Adam Schiff, a Democrat from California, was just last week named the ranking Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee. He joins us now live here on set. Congressman, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
So I guess the big confusion here is AQAP and ISIS, because Coulibaly released a video pledging allegiance to ISIS, but the Kouachi brothers claimed allegiance to AQAP, and now AQAP seems to be verifying the name. How does that work? Are these two groups working together now, you think?
Well, I think the leadership of the two groups is not working together, and indeed, in many cases in Syria, they have fought each other.
Right.
But outside of the theater of war, it certainly appears that those collisions and conflicts are less important to some of the people who are radicalized. And in France, as in probably the United States, Europe, and elsewhere, you have people that have a closer affinity to one or the other, some that have been just radicalized online, and maybe the message of ISIL and the caliphate resonates more. Others may have actually received training or support from AQAP, as may have been the case here with the Kouachi brothers. And plainly, they don't have a problem working together overseas to attack Western targets.
Right.
So those distinctions, which may matter to the leadership of those organizations, may be of far less importance to people radicalized out around the world.
Now, AQAP has been claiming responsibility in some fort for this operation since last week when they told Jeremy Scahill, who's a reporter for The Intercept. How seriously a role, what exact role does the intelligence community in this country think AQAP played? Did they come up with the whole plan? Was this the exact idea, attack these offices at this time? Or was it more like they trained these guys, they sent them out there to the West, and things just happened?
Yeah. The short answer is we don't know yet. It's certainly very plausible that at least one of the brothers was in Yemen, had an association with AQAP. We're still trying to verify that, but it's also very possible that the instructions, the support, the training they got wasn't directed in a time, place, and manner. In other words, you're going to wait for 4 years or 5 years, and then you're going to attack this location. Here's how you're going to do it. It may very well be the case that AQAP has tried to recruit Westerners, which they have. They have given them financing, which they have. They have sent them back with general targets, or maybe them to read Inspire magazine and get cues on targets.
Right.
It's interesting that AQAP doesn't assert that they had command and control, as in proximate instructions to these brothers. And it may be, frankly, you have cases where people go to Syria or Iraq or elsewhere. They think they want to join the jihad. They come back, and all of a sudden in Paris, it doesn't look like such a good idea. And these brothers may have decided to do other things when they got back to France, and something set them off, which doesn't have to be an AQAP instruction. They don't have to be sort of the spy novel kind of sleeper cell. It may be that things in their lives weren't going well, and they decide, okay, this is the time to fall through.
And we should mention that the Al-Qaeda magazine Inspire did list, they had a wanted list, a target list, and Shab, the editor of Charlie Hebdo, was one of the people on that list. What is the latest intelligence on whether or not the Kouachi brothers or Coulibaly or Boumediene, the woman who's still wanted, contacted anyone in the United States?
Well, we don't have evidence yet, I think, that there's a connection between these attackers in France and some ongoing cell or plot in the United States. Obviously, excuse me, that's our highest priority, finding out do they have Confederates here, and helping the French identify who else may be involved in the cell there. A lot of information going back and forth between the U.S. and France. At this point, though, there's no sense of collaborators working on a plot here in the homeland. We are taking those additional steps, security steps, some disclosed, some not disclosed, because you always have the danger of copycats, even if there is no direct connection. And you better believe that the intelligence community right now is concerned that people that we have had in mind and under surveillance and been watching, because they have been either radicalized or exposed to radicals, we have to worry about them deciding to become active.
But no concrete evidence of any plots.
No.
Just precautions based on what happened.
Absolutely.
Congressman Adam Schiff, thank you so much. Really appreciate your time.